myself in a space where I had to make the most difficult decision in my life, and it wasn't quite an easy decision to make, mainly because it didn't just affect me, it affected people around me, or you know, my mindset as well. So if I can tell you my story, I think let me talk about my tertiary life. In tertiary, I never really had a problem of trying to hustle and find a way to make money. So what I used to do, I used to sell like Avon products and either do like projects, school projects for other students, and then they would pay me and all that. So there's always been a way for me to make money. And I think even on second, if not, yeah, during my second, if not third year, I was also a student assistant or a tutor, if you call it that way, where I used to, you know, get paid for helping out in terms of programming languages, assisting other students and all that. So there's always been a way for me to actually make money. So when I found myself in a situation where I had to now make a decision to quit my job, it was actually quite a very difficult thing to do, and mainly because it's something that I'm not used to, and something that I never thought it would happen, maybe not as yet, because I feel like I was not 100% ready for that. But unfortunately it happened because my health was affected and a lot of things were getting affected, and I realized that, you know what, if my health is affected and I am underperforming, this thing is actually dealing with two things that are going on in my life. First of all, I'm that kind of person who wants to leave a mark in whatever that I do. So if I'm gonna do something and I don't do it to my full capacity, I feel like I'm a failure. That's just me. Not that I doubt myself or anything, but I feel like I need to always make a mark in whatever that I'm doing and make a difference and leave a mark. Even if, you know, I leave tomorrow, there should be something that is said about this person that, yeah, you know what, we had a great asset in the business and all that. So that is just me. So negativity somehow puts me down or kind of drags me. So I didn't want that in my life. So when I found myself in a situation where I had to quit my job, I really, really was not okay. And also mainly because I was faced with the fact that I had responsibility. You know, as a black child, there are so many responsibilities that we have. I mean, I was building a house at the time, like finishing my family's house that I was building. I'll share the suggestion on the top there. You can check it out. You can check the video whenever you have time on the process and everything. But the fact that there were responsibilities that I had to do, it was quite difficult for me to deal with the fact that I would be out of job. And obviously, if you know me, you would think that, but you have your own company, how come you are dealing with all of that? Well, I do have my own company, but something that you might want to know is that I actually worked on my company part-time and had a full-time job, which was one of the things that kind of affected my health, because I had to work full-time and then after work I had to do my company on the side, and sometimes on weekends. Actually, not sometimes, most of the time was weekends. And it got to me, guys, health-wise. My doctor even told me that I had symptoms of stroke, which was quite difficult for me, you know, at the time. So yeah, you can imagine how, you know, all of that is. But my message to someone who might have lost their job or who might have went through a situation where they had to quit or had to resign for whatever reason, or lost their jobs for whatever reason that could be there, I just want to tell you that the mindset that you have will actually help you get out of the current situation that you're in. And I will tell you one thing, this is not a very easy thing. This is not something easy. It's not easy. I can tell you now that as much as I'm running my own business full time now, it is actually not easy at this point, because today you get a business, tomorrow you don't get a business. It's not really that easy, but you keep pushing. So the mindset that I have is actually helping me to stay focused and focus on what can be done in the business. So the mindset that you have will actually help you to get out of any situation. I know it could be difficult. There are people depending on you and all that, and now the salary that you were getting every month is not coming and all that. But dwelling much on that will not actually help you, but instead it will actually drag you down, and it will somehow strain you. And when you are strained, you are not able to focus or think clearly or think of the next plan in your life. So my point is, have a positive mindset in everything and think of the next plan. And some people would always say, quit a job when you have a plan. Sometimes, unfortunately, it's not the case. I've always thought that I would actually quit my day job when I'm sure that my business will actually function on its own and all that. I wasn't ready. So I wasn't actually ready to quit my job just like that. Though obviously I had the plan in mind that one day I will actually quit my job, but I was not ready at the time. But like, my message to you, if you find yourself in a position where somehow this happens and then you didn't have anything to do or any idea or any plan in hand, what I can advise you with is that, you know what, this is life. Life happens. Sometimes you will be faced with situations where you have to make decisions that you never thought you would. But that mindset of believing the fact that, you know what, no matter what is happening, you will actually overcome, will actually help you. I used to consider myself the most strongest person, but I have my breaking moments. And on this day on its own, I found myself wanting to cry many times because of, you know, everything that I would think of, things that are happening and all that. But I got to now think of the things that I'm grateful for, things that are positive that are happening. Because when you focus on things that are positive, things that are actually going great, you are able to actually transfer the energy to the things that are not going so great, and somehow to somehow help yourself be in the right direction and dealing with, you know, your current situation. So obviously, it's not easy to say, hey, you're out of job and you just have to be a focused person and be hopeful and all that. But I mean, I'm a believer of God, and I believe that God is actually the center. God is actually the way, the truth and the light, and there is really nothing we can do without him. And you know, funny enough, I was on Instagram watching, you know, some of the videos, and I came across my cousin's video, and the song that he was singing really resonated with me, because I think if there's something about music, it can actually make a difference in your life. And you know, it was a song of hope, and it says, be still and know that I am God. And I think that at this point, we need to be still and know that God cannot actually put us in any situations that we cannot deal with and all that. So I think I'll play a little bit of what his song is and what he was actually saying. And yeah.
It's been bothering me for a while, but at the same time, encouraging me. Hoping in my heart that wherever you are, somehow you're finding the crack in these dark times to shine.
Find the crack in these dark times.
Find that joy.
Find that joy. Find that love. Find that positivity in you. Because God is there.
And all the above.
And he says, be still and know that I'm here.
Keep the faith.
Keep the faith.
Because he says,
my God. Listen, listen to that.
Yeah.
He's still and know that I am God.
Says it again, it says, be still.
Okay, I'm not gonna go on because I'm not the most amazing singer, but yeah, that message says, be still and know that I am God. And this is a message to you to say, even if you find yourself in a situation where you can't really control things, be still and know that God is there. So do not lose hope. Your mindset needs to be positive at all times. And how I've been keeping my mind positive is that I've been consistent throughout the time and, you know, looking for ways to actually better the situation that I could find myself in. I mean, imagine you have just quit your job a few months ago and then the next thing, lockdown happens, and then you like, what is happening? Just when you thought you'll just, you know, keep pushing and then look for business, go around looking for business. Where do you go when there's lockdown and all that? So I had to find ways. And I believe that throughout this time, God has actually been there and helped me to get throughout, like to get through the entire situation. And if God can do this to me or do this for me, He can actually do it for you. And you need to also believe in yourself enough that, you know what, throughout everything that is happening, you can't actually find ways to blame things that are around you or people that are around you or the situation around you. But instead, you need to focus on what is it that you can change? What is it that you can improve from your current situation? And that's how we actually get better in life and improve in whatever that we wish to do in life. We get better by working on ourselves, by working on the things that we can change and avoid things that we can't change, because time wasted never regains. So the time that you waste on something that you cannot change can't actually help you in any way. So focus on what you can change, and yeah, stick to that and believe that, you know what, tomorrow will be a better day. So being hopeful, I think that is actually what keeps me going. And I believe that, you know what, the sun will always shine on me. God will always make a way for me. Even in the darkest times, God will find a way to make that way for me. So you have to believe it in yourself and trust in God to actually make the way. You know what, I'm starting to preach right now, but like the whole motive of this video was to just give a bit of hope to someone who has lost their jobs or who finds themselves having to quit and, yeah, be out of work and all that. But with that said, do not give up. Do not give up. You have the skill, work on yourself and do something better that will, you know, make a difference tomorrow. So with that said, thank you so much for watching, and yeah, please do subscribe to my channel. And for everyone that has subscribed, I appreciate you and I love you, and yeah, you are amazing. Thank you so much. Yeah, it's a bit of an emotional moment, but yeah, I'm grateful for everything, and I think you should also be grateful for everything. All right, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.
It says it again, it says, be still.